This is the new Laowa 7.5mm f2 lens for Micro Four Third cameras. It is not a 100% brand new lens, but if you already have the original version, there are some pretty important changes that may make you consider upgrading to this latest version. Kiala, good morning everyone, Richuan here. Welcome back to the channel. Today we are looking at the update version of the Laowa 7.5mm f2 lens. This is a lens that is specially designed for Micro Four Third cameras, and it is a slightly unusual video for me because I have done a review of this lens a couple of years ago, and that was actually my first ever review that I done on YouTube. So this time, because I want to compare my latest results and my thoughts with what I thought about a couple of years ago, so I have to rewatch my old video, and that's slightly painful experience because I found that video is quite painful to watch. But anyway, that's maybe just me. So I think a lot of you guys are quite familiar with this lens because it has been around for a while, and some of you may already have one in your camera bag. So I thought I should start this review by talking about the biggest difference between this update version and the original version. So I think that's something that a lot of you guys will be most interested in. And after that, if you are someone who not really familiar with the lens, I will continue and talk about the design, the build quality, and also the image quality of this lens. Laowa has officially joined the Micro Four Thirds group last year, and since then they have released a couple of new lenses that has the electronic support, and this new Laowa 7.5mm lens also has the electronic contacts. So there are a few big advantages that comes with that. The first thing is the camera will know the information of the lens that you are using, so you will know what is the name of the lens, what is the focal length of the lens, and also what is the aperture that you chose. So what that means is, first thing, if you look at the JPEG or the RAW file that you captured, you can see all the details there. And that also means if you have a lens correction profile for this lens, you can now automatically apply, or much easier apply, to the photo that you shot with this lens. And another advantage is when you mount the lens on the camera no longer need to ask you what is the focal length of the lens that you are using. And this is especially useful for people who shoot with quite a few different lenses and constantly swapping between lenses, because you no longer have to set the focal length every time you change the lens. The lens also has the auto aperture feature. What that means is when you stop down the lens, the aperture wouldn't stop down immediately. So it will only stop down when you take the photo or when you apply the depth of field preview. And there are some big advantage comes with it. The first one is, because the aperture is not stopped down all the time, that means the camera sensor doesn't have to boost the light when you are previewing. So this is not a big problem for a mirrorless camera compared to DSLR, because DSLR you have the optical viewfinder, so the camera can't do much, it can't boost the image that is reflected through the mirrors. But for mirrorless camera, the sensor can boost the signal that it received, so you can still see a bright image, but the preview would be a lot noisier than it should be. So with the auto aperture feature, then you won't have this problem with your preview. Your preview would always be pretty nice. And the other advantage, which is a bigger advantage in my opinion, is because the lens doesn't stop down, so you will be previewing at the widest aperture. That means your depth of field would be quite a bit narrower than if you choose f8, for example. Then the depth of field, actual depth of field, would be quite a lot deeper. So the advantage of doing the preview and doing the focusing at f2 compared to f8 is your depth of field is a lot more narrower, so it just makes it a lot easier to do precise menu focusing. And another big advantage compared to the original version, which I think is the biggest advantage if you ask me, is that when you adjust the focus, as soon as you touch the menu focus ring, the camera would immediately pop up a magnifying view. Of course, that really depends on the camera you use or the setting that you choose, but I personally really prefer to use the magnifying view when I do menu focus, because I don't really like using peaking. I find peaking is just not really accurate for me. With this Laowa 7.5mm lens, the camera will automatically pop up the magnifying view as soon as I touch the menu focus ring. So to me, that makes menu focus just a lot easier and a lot faster compared to other menu focus lenses that doesn't have the electronic support. Apart from not having autofocus, shooting with this Laowa lens feel pretty much exactly the same as shooting with a native Panasonic or Olympus lens on the Micro Four Thirds camera. The only thing that does not work is when you are doing menu focus, like on this Panasonic camera, you will see there's like a scale thing on the screen that show you what is the focus distance that you currently set to. So when you're adjusting it with a Panasonic lens, for example, you can see there's a dot that would move across that scale. With the Laowa lens, it seems like they have not implemented that feature, so you cannot see that scale updated at all. For myself, I never really rely on that feature because that scale is never accurate, but I thought I should mention because some of you may find that feature very important. This update version of the Laowa 7.5mm lens can communicate with the camera. So when you want to change the aperture, you can just do it on the camera body using the camera dial. Laowa has removed the aperture ring because it's no longer needed, and probably because of that, the lens is also a little bit lighter as well. The new version is only 150 gram, which is about 20 gram lighter than the original version. So 20 gram does not sound like a lot, but if you are someone who put this lens and the camera on a gimbal or put it on a drone, then 20 gram could be quite a big difference. Another big difference between this new updated version and the original version is this lens now has a 5 aperture braid design compared to the original version, which has a 7 aperture braid design. It seems like Laowa really love to put 5 aperture braid on their ultra wide angle lenses. Some of the other ultra wide angle Laowa lenses that I've tested, I think all of them has the 5 aperture braid design. So the advantage of that is that it can give you some beautiful 10-pound Sunstars when you stop down the lens. So we'll have a look at the Sunstars later on in this video as well. Okay, so these are the biggest difference between the new update version and the original version. So now let's have a look at the design and build quality of this lens. This Laowa 7.5mm f2 lens is a very compact and very lightweight lens. The size and weight of this lens is only marginally bigger or heavier than the ultra compact 10mm f2 lens also from Laowa. The weight I mentioned before is only 150 gram. So yeah, when you pair it with pretty much any Micro Four Thirds camera, even the smallest Micro Four Thirds camera, the lens still feel very balanced when you put it on that. And when you put it on one of the bigger Micro Four Thirds camera like this Lumix GH5 Mark II, now the lens actually looks a little bit small, like look a little bit funny when it is mounted on the camera. This lens has a very solid and metal construction. As I've mentioned just before, it does not have an aperture ring because you can change the aperture from the camera dial. The menu focus ring feels very smooth and it has a hard stop on both ends. The focus flow is around 90 degrees, which I think is pretty perfect for a lens like this. The lens has a 46mm front filter thread, So if you are planning to use this lens to take some landscape photo, you can easily attach your CPL or ND filter in front of the lens. I remember when Laowa released the 10mm f2 lens a couple of months ago, a lot of you guys asked me the question, hey Richard, you have reviewed both of these lenses. They are so similar, they are both specially designed for micro four foot cameras, they are both compact, both wide angle, and they are both f2 aperture, so which one should I choose? Now, back then, the 10mm has the electronic contacts while the 7.5mm didn't have. So one of the reasons why you may prefer the 10mm lens is because it's easier to use compared to the 7.5mm lens. But now Laowa has updated this 7.5mm lens and also give it the same treatment. So that's no longer a difference between those two lenses. While the image quality from these two lenses has a little bit of difference, but I think the biggest difference is the focal length, or I should say the field of view. 7.5mm and 10mm does not sound like a huge difference, but look at these two side-by-side photos that I shot, one at 7.5mm and the other one at 10mm. Now I do not have the 10mm Laowa with me, so this 10mm photo was shot using the Leica 10-25mm lens at 10mm. But you can see there is quite a big difference in terms of the field of view between a 7.5mm lens and a 10mm lens. And that's something that you have to decide which one is the more suitable lens for you. If you want to do some vlogging, both these lenses are actually very suitable for that because the field of view are both quite wide and that is pretty much perfect for vlogging. The 7.5mm lens is wider, which means you could hold the camera slightly closer to you, which may mean your hand won't get so tired so quickly. But at the same time, because it's wider, so it will have a little bit more distortion, and you can also see sometimes when the IBIS is trying to compensate or correct the camera shake, there could be a little bit of wobbly effect near the corner or edge of the frame. So it has nothing to do with the lens itself, it's just the nature of using ultra wide angle lens and rely on the IBIS to do the image stabilization. Okay, now let's talk about the image quality and start from the image sharpness. The center sharpness of this lens is already excellent at the maximum aperture f2. So when I stop down the lens, the center sharpness doesn't really change much at all. And if you look at the corner, at the maximum aperture f2, the corner sharpness is also pretty good. But if I stop down the lens to f2.8 or f4, then the corner sharpness does improve a little bit. In terms of distortion, Laowa is really famous for their COD or COD distortion lenses, but this 7.5mm lens is not a COD lens. So I'm not really surprised that I can see a bit of distortion in some of my test photos. But having said that, for a 7.5mm micro four foot lens, I think the amount of distortion is really acceptable. Chromatic aberration is reasonably well controlled. Most of the photo I shot, I see no color fringing at all. In a few very high contrast test photo, I do see a small amount of color fringing, but I don't think it is very serious. When I did my original Laowa 7.5mm review, I said lens flare is probably the biggest weakness of this lens, and I think I still agree with that. By no means the lens flare is terrible with this lens, and in a lot of photos and video I shot, I see very minimal amount of lens flare, but when I'm shooting some of the most challenging test photo and video, I would sometimes see quite a bit of lens flare, especially at the opposite side to the bright light source. Vignetting is quite noticeable at the maximum aperture f2 or even f2.8. It becomes much better when I stop down to around f4 and onwards, but still, even when I stop down all the way to f8, I can still see quite a bit of vignetting. I think that is just a bit of trade-off when you have a ultra wide-angle lens that is such small and compact. Quite a few of you have asked me in the past whether this Laowa lens is good for astrophotography or not, so I shot some quick photo in my garden and have a look at this photo. This was shot at f2. and I think the result is not too bad. Even when I look at the corners, the amount of coma is at a pretty acceptable level. As I have mentioned earlier in this review, one of the changes of this new version compared to the original one is that now the aperture braid, it has a 5 aperture braid design. So this would give us a 10 points sunstar when you stop down the lens. So when you stop down the lens to around f5.6, you can now start to see those 10 points sunstars. When shooting at f16 or f22, the sunstars become very sharp and very nice looking. Now, sunstars is quite a subjective thing, but for me, I really love the sunstar come from this new version of the Laowa 7.5mm lens. For an ultra wide angle lens, bokeh is usually not that important, but because this lens does have a fast f2 aperture, so when you are shooting close up photos, you could still dissolve the background a little bit. When shooting at f2, the bokeh is nice and round with very nice fall off at the edge of the bokeh. But once you stop down the lens to f2.8, because of its 5 braid aperture design, the bokeh would now turn into a pentagon shape and it will remain like that when you stop down the lens further. If you are someone who prefers the more rounded bokeh and you do plan to shoot a lot of close-up photos, then the original 7.5mm lens may be the better choice for you. This Laowa 7.5mm f2 lens is exactly how I remember it is. It is a very solid lens in terms of both the build quality and image quality. Yes, there are a couple of things that I wish Laowa can improve a little bit. For example, the amount of lens flare and vignetting. I wish they can both be a little bit less. But consider, this is such a compact and lightweight lens. I think Laowa should be really proud of it. And now, adding the electronic support to the lens make this lens a lot more practical and a lot easier to use. So I think if you are currently already have a 7.5mm f2 lens in your camera bag and if you use it a lot, you really should consider whether you should upgrade to this latest version or not. And if you don't have one and we're thinking about whether you should get it or not, I think now it is a good time to get this update version of the Laowa 7.5mm f2 lens.